Samoans that are here in the States, we all still have one thing, and that's just the love that we continue to share. It's the respect.
There's something about fellowshipping with my people. Amen? And I'm not really good at speaking Samoan, but again, it's my job to build that bridge with my three children who were basically raised in a Malauulu church.
I know no matter where we go, what church that we go to, but our heart is always here at USC. It's always good to be back.
God created them perfectly the way they are. So if you have, or if you were that child that was maybe a little bit more ulapani, you know, out of your siblings, like twins, Raisa, I know Raisa, she's the more ulapani. But if you were, that's okay, because God created you that way for a reason. And there's a plan and purpose already for you. So don't change because, oh, she's so good and she never gets in trouble and she's so smart and I'm not as smart. Sometimes our peer pressures are even within our own home, within our own siblings. No, remember, God created, like we heard yesterday, you were fearfully and wonderfully made. That is a fact. You were fearfully and wonderfully made. God knows. He knew you in your mother's womb. If Jesus came out, I'm going to heaven. because in my mind, I believe with all my heart, I accepted Christ. So I'm seeing, I didn't understand that there was more to it than that. I didn't understand that there was supposed to be a change in my lifestyle, that my life should be reflecting Christ, that my life should be about Him, about what He wants. I understood now that it was a relationship between me and Christ. It wasn't about the Sunday service. It wasn't about the active Congolian where I was. It wasn't about me being a Sunday school teacher or active in where I was at. It was really about my relationship with Christ. And what does that mean? Okay, this is how I kind of break down my kids. Think about the one person you care about so much.
And your children, arise with yourself. Be trustworthy in your husband. Trust your children. Because God will speak through you and through your children.
So I was born on the 10th. Only if I eat a spoon of life up here. Only I have a family of the day.
I'm a diamond of my family. No, no, Father, no more than you already gave me. That's my time in my mind. The tower, here on the mother, the step mother. Only step monster.
How do the bad attitudes look like? What do?
Like rolling your eyes. Like, if you don't want to talk to them, then you, like, slam the door.
Stomp your feet. You guys don't do that. What do you possess?
Bravery.
You have bravery?
Being brave, but, like,
by showing you're not scared.
No, not
towards brave. What, though?
Towards fear, people.
Like, towards people?
Like, you're scared. R
is real. Like, be real with yourself and your relationship with God. T is trust in God. U is understand God. O is obedience.
Already we've defeated ourselves. I'm not going to even take that first step of trying to walk with the Lord because I don't want to lose them. Where is that coming from?
We saw all these, he saw these kids that don't have shoes and their uniforms are dirty and they didn't have uniforms. So God showed him that and he wanted to help these kids. So for his birthday, instead of having a birthday party, he asked them to bring money to donate to the campaign.
Confession, role model, yourself, the way you act, positive, caring.
Yeah, so you have a choice to either, you can look at, you can see a situation and think that there's something wrong about it, or you can pray about it and hopefully your mind set will. We have to accept the fact that we're going to fail and that without Him, we're truly just going to fail and stay there. But with Him, we'll be able to rise again and He'll be able to guide us in the way that He wants us to. Your relationship with God, it has to be something that's not just daily, but just all the time.
Proverbs 3, 5, and 6. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not on your own understanding.
And our prayers is that we continue to fellowship like this. And I know God hears our prayers. He will make an avenue, an open door doors for us to come together in His name.
Oh.
do not come every day. Thank you for being in touch with today, Lord. Thank you for being in. When they do come, we have to grab them because they may never come in. Faatai to everybody who helped put this Virtuous Woman Conference in reality. God has his ways.